Hey everyone, it's Megan, the Crafty Quinn, and today I'm sharing 7 neutral and modern farmhouse decor and ornament ideas using mostly Dollar Tree products. I hope you guys enjoy these, so let's get crafting! Okay, so for the first idea, you're going to need this wood ornament cutout from the Dollar Tree, or you can use one of their other wood round cutouts from the Crafter Square section. I painted this white, drilled a hole in the top using a 5/16 of an inch drill bit, and you're going to want to paint the top of this ornament gray, so I used Waverly's mineral color. Then, to give this the appearance of the top of an ornament, I drew white lines at the top to give it a shiny look. And now it's time for the Crafty Kitty to make his entrance. I'm so glad to see he's interested in my crafting again. Next, you're going to want to take some string and feed a loop through the hole you've drilled to hang your wood beads. I grabbed a few wooden beads of the same size to be a topper for this ornament. In the meantime, while I waited for my words to print, I tied a quick little bow to this string right below the beads. You're going to have this ornament say Jingle Bells, as you can probably guess. You'll notice that I did add a little bit of Waverly Antique Wax to the edges of this ornament, and that's just to give this a little more definition and add to its farmhouse charm. And the ribbon is actually also from Dollar Tree as well. Here's the finished product when it's hanging on your tree, and I just love it. So this next idea came to me when I saw this front door looking ornament from Dollar Tree, and when I saw this house decor piece also from Dollar Tree, I knew I wanted to turn that into some kind of display. So what we're going to do first is sand this house down to get rid of those dark flowers in the back, which will make this easier to paint all white. And if you don't have a finger sander, what are you waiting for? Pick one up for yourself. Give your hands a break. I have this one linked down in my description box for you. So we're going to paint this door next as well. I did sand this down as well to get rid of the glitter on the door. And I'm using white Waverly chalk paint here with my foam brush and all throughout this project. I use a lot of this color. And I'm basically going to keep repeating a lot of the same colors actually for most of these projects because they were just next to me. So then you're going to want to paint the pieces of the door that pop out with Waverly's black paint. This one's called Ink. You may be wondering where the holes of the ornament at the top have gone, and I actually covered them up with spackle. I painted over it once again, so I did 2 coats of the white chalk paint. And once you have your house painted white, it's time to add the shiplap background with scrapbook paper from Hobby Lobby or wherever you feel. I got it for 69 cents. I'm using Dollar Tree Matte Mod Podge. The scrapbook paper wasn't my original intent for this project, but I'm so glad I added this in. Once you have an even layer of Mod Podge, lay down your scrapbook paper and roll over it a few times with a roller. I do have this particular roller linked down for you below in my description box, and I recommend adding some heat to it with a hairdryer or a heat gun to lock it in and get rid of any last remaining air bubbles. This trick works well with fabric that you may be using Mod Podge to stick with, and lately I've noticed how well it can work for scrapbook paper too if you're not too aggressive with the heat. So next we're gluing down our front door. And now with the winter scene, it can really start to come together. This is the original wreath that I'm going to be adding next. This came with the ornament that was red. And we're just going to place this now at the top of my little house using some hot glue. Next, I'm adding a small black and white gingham style bow to this wreath, and that really ties in the farmhouse look. Then as a finishing touch, I'm sorry it's hard to see, but I am adding trees that they come in a pack of two from Dollar Tree, and then I add some faux snow to the bottom as well. That of course comes out every Christmas time. And so I actually used Mod Podge to make the faux snow stick. And as a final touch, I used white puffy paint that I've been using for everything lately, and I put snow on the roof and on the steps of the house. And I even added a little of the white puffy paint to the top of the door, so it really looks like it's just snowed. So the goal here is to really make this look like a winter scene in front of a modern farmhouse. And here's the finished product. It's my little winter modern farmhouse scape. It's super easy to make. It just takes a little bit of extra love and time if you've got it. So I found this wood sled at Dollar Tree earlier on in the decor season, but you may still be able to find it. I'm using a gray stain for this. It's called Premium Barnwood Gray Wax by Craftsmart from Michaels. I actually got it on sale at the time in their clearance bin. I couldn't believe no one wanted this beautiful color stain. So if you're going to want to stain, you're going to want to stain this entire sled gray, except for the top rail, using a paper towel to help spread it around. And you, of course, don't have to use gray stain. You can use any gray paint that you want. So for this top rail, I'm painting it black and I'm using Waverly's ink color again. And I don't show it, but I took a wood snowflake cutout as a last embellishment from Dollar Tree. And it doesn't have to be this particular snowflake wood cutout. They have many different kinds of little snowflakes. And I painted it white and I hot glued it to the middle of the sled or the seat, and no other steps are really needed once it dries. So this is one of the crafts that I mentioned was going to be super, super easy. If you were following me on my community tab of my channel, I mentioned I have some crafts for you that don't really have a whole ton of steps, and this is one of them. I know the last project was a lot, but I promise they are easy. This project was actually inspired by a similar ornament that my mom actually made to sell at her local flea market, and I loved it and I had to make a version of my own. So thank you for the inspiration, Mom. So like I said, my name is Megan, M-E-G-A-N, and this is my crafty assistant Marcus, aka the Crafty Kitty. This is a quick reminder to please hit that thumbs up button if you're liking the DIYs, and please make sure to also subscribe and select notifications by hitting the bell button so you never miss a new video. Now, let's head back to the crafts. So for this fourth DIY, you're going to need three of these new triangle frames. My Dollar Tree seems to have a surplus of them, so if you're local, check out the Chantilly, Virginia Dollar Tree for these. And you're going to need a two-pack of Dollar Tree gift bags, or gift bags of your choosing from anywhere. To make the gift bags fit just right for this frame, I did have to cut into it and open it up a little wider. I used the side of the gift bags that were the least creased for these signs. Once I trace the frame over the gift bag and cut it down to size using the frame, I'm using Mod Podge now to hold the cutout gift bag in the frame. I spread out the Mod Podge to create an even layer and get rid of bubbles, and I pressed down in all corners, and I did use my hairdryer for some heat activation. It also helped get rid of some of the bag creases as well, so that was really great. And then for the third frame, I painted it all black on the inside, and I painted three more of those wood snowflake cutouts I painted them white, and then I hot glued them evenly spaced apart as best you can throughout the frame. I love how modern and chic these turned out. I've been wanting to make these ever since I got this gift bag set, and now my vision has come to life and I'm obsessed with these. For this next craft, I'm repurposing a beaded sign from Dollar Tree. They seem to sell more and more of these now every day. This one was not a holiday sign, but I'm definitely making it one now. We're going to take some 69-cent scrapbook paper from Hobby Lobby once again and adhere it using, you guessed it, Mod Podge. Clearly, I've gotten over my fear of it, so thank you all for your advice and tips. They have been much appreciated. So we're doing an even layer there, and once you have your scrapbook paper down and using the steps that I showed you in my previous crafts, you can pop it back into your frame. I prefer to lay my white vinyl frays down this way so I can get the spacing just right and just see where it aligns with the frame. But since I am placing this down on scrapbook paper, I wasn't taking into account the stickiness of the transfer tape, and it did damage the paper. So I probably could have put a layer of Mod Podge on top of the scrapbook paper to protect it and then lay down the Let's Get Cozy vinyl frays. As you can see there, it's definitely starting to pull up some of the scrapbook paper with it. And the font on this phrasing was just so thin that it ended up taking some of the G with it. So since I messed this up a little bit, I did sand it down to even it out and make it look more rustic. And I'm even going over the vinyl with my finger sander. Once all that's done, I added two tiny trees from Dollar Tree's Tiny Christmas Tree Multipack, and since this sign is all about being cozy, I thought putting two trees there would be perfect for this, and I think it's pretty adorable. So for the sixth decor idea, I'm taking a holiday card from this Dollar Tree holiday card set of 12, and I'm going to cut the card in half. This red truck was just too irresistible not to make something with it. Next, you're going to need two small size Dollar Tree blank canvases, and you're going to rip the canvas off and keep the frame. It pops off pretty easily. Now, since the card is not an exact fit, we're going to lay it on some shiplap scrapbook paper and then use the frame to trace it out. Before you add the card to the frames though, you're going to want to stain them with some antique wax, or you could use coffee, diluted brown paint, whatever you feel like. And I'm just using a paper towel to spread it around. We're next just going to hot glue everything together and put the card with the frame. I just put some dabs of hot glue in each corner. Once you have the first frame down, then you're good to lay down the second frame, locking it in, and I use the inside of the card for the back of this framed card. Here's how it turned out, and I feel like this is the perfect personalized gift if you want to do something more than just a Christmas card, and you could even sign the card on the back. Now for my final DIY idea, these little frames from Dollar Tree make adorable ornaments. I did leave the little picture frame stand on the back of them. You never know if you want to repurpose them at a later time. I'm just taking a little tiny screwdriver that I have from Hobby Lobby from my hammer screwdriver set, and you are going to need to unscrew the clips from the frames. There is barely anything to this DIY. You just need some wood shapes, and you can just stain them and then hot glue them, and then that's really all there is to it. I added some twine to the back to turn them into ornaments, but like I said, you could just leave these as frames as well. So I am staining once again with my Waverly Antique Wax. These are all the wood cutout shapes from Dollar Tree's Christmas section. You can use whichever shapes you want. Like I said, there's barely anything to this DIY, and then you have two adorable little ornaments. Thank you guys so much for watching. If you want to check out more of my Christmas videos, check them out here on the left, and let's keep in touch on Instagram. See you guys next time. Thank you again so much for watching. I really appreciate it.